Hey guys, Piet Kalamijn here. Today I want to make a quick video for you on how you can do a short spice simulation within Altium. So this is something I always used LTSpice for that, or more specific PSpice and other programs. But LTSpice is a standalone simulation that you can do for a circuit, and then afterwards you make your circuit in Altium. Now I want to quickly show you today how you can do that directly within Altium. This is of course for basic filters that I'm going to show with you to you today, but you can also do that for more specific models. If you have an LTSpice model for, let's say, an op-amp, you can bring that into Altium as well and use it for simulation. So I'm going to quickly show you today how we can simulate a very basic filter. So we're going to simulate a high pass and a low pass filter. Now first of all, important is that you have the system extension for the mixed simulation. If you do not have that, what you will see that is if you are in a schematic, then you will not have this simulation box. So that's an important one. Now let's have a look on this filter. So I have used very simple schematic over here. There's a capacitor, there's a resistor. Of course, you can go into more depth into that with more specific filters, much more interesting stuff than this. But it's to show you the principle. Now, if you remember the basic cutoff frequency, or the minus 3 dB cutoff frequency, that's 1 divided by 2 pi times the resistance times the capacitance. So if we are using a 1 microfarad capacitor and a 1K resistor, I would expect the cutoff frequency to be somewhere around 160 Hz. If I'm going to make this capacitor smaller, the cutoff frequency will increase, and that in that case, if we would use 10 nanofarad, it will increase up to 15.9 kHz. So that's all good and well, but we want to simulate it and see if that's indeed exact to our calculations. So what you can do is via simulate, you can place a source. You would place a voltage source in there. And then once that is placed, that voltage source, you edit the properties of that. In the properties, you can select the stimulus type. So I'm going to use a sine wave. If you would apply DC voltage source, of course, you would not see anything happening in the filter. So sinusoidal, it's important that you have an AC magnitude, an amplitude specified as well. And I always specify some frequency. So if you're doing transient analysis, that you see something happening as well. Okay, so once that is done, so for these, make sure that you just use the generic cap, generic res components from Altium. They are in the miscellaneous devices int library. It's always standard installed in Altium. Now then, if you want to simulate, you go to simulation dashboard. You will get a pop-out. You can put it on the side if you wish. And the most important thing is that you make sure that you update before you do anything. So update, that means if you generate your netlist, that it should look okay. If you're familiar with SPICE or LTSPICE, this will look familiar to you as well. So what you see over here is that we have an AC analysis that is already, that will be done on that input sine wave. Then you have your capacitor, you have your resistor. Good. So operating point, we can simulate that if you want. DC sweep, so that's basically transient analysis. The transient is below DC sweep, that would be sweeping your input DC voltage. Transient, you can set that as well. We can quickly check that. And then you have an AC sweep. So today, the AC sweep over here, we will sweep. I always like to have a nice boat plot, so magnitude dB is what I would select. It has selected it twice because it was already selected over here. So I want to have a standard boat plot for that, both for the input and the output. You can do advanced settings, but in fact, most interesting thing here is we're going to sweep from 1 Hz to 1 MHz with 100 points per decade. So if we go ahead and do that, what you see happening is exactly the boat plot that you would expect. So you have an input that is, of course, not attenuated. And then you have your output, V load, which is attenuated. It is a high pass filter. So, of course, the low frequencies, they are cut off or attenuated. If we would place a marker over here. So let's check with our cursor, the minus 3 dB point somewhere over here. Minus 3 dB, we are at 157, so 157 Hz. So what we calculated. So what we calculated over here was also this 159 hertz. So you see that it exactly matches, of course, what you would expect. Now let's say that we change this capacitance to 10 nanofarads. Then you would expect, of course, the cutoff frequency to be much higher. So I'm going to do that over here, like this. Important again is to update your netlist so that everything is correct. And then if we do our sweep again, so we used to be at around 160 hertz cutoff frequency. Right now, if you look over here, so let's use a cursor again. If I put that at minus 3 dBs, more or less, okay, then we get a cutoff frequency of 16 kilohertz. It's not exactly at minus 3 dBs, but that's exactly what we would expect. 16 kilohertz, we calculate 15.9. So you can also do the reverse thing if you would like to, let's say, evaluate a low-pass filter. So I'm going to quickly change this over here. Put this here, this one over here. So what you will see, of course, is that the cutoff frequency will not change. That's the same, but you will of course see that there is now low pass behavior rather than the high pass behavior. So quickly drawing that looks a bit ugly, but should do the trick for now. So again, you update, you do the sweep. And rather than having the low frequencies attenuated, we now have the high frequencies attenuated. And you see the cutoff frequency again. So exactly what we would expect should be at our 16 kilohertz. So let's draw it to minus 3 dBs more or less. Something like this. Again, around 16 kilohertz. So I hope this was interesting for you. A very quick walkthrough on how to do schematic simulations, so integrated SPI simulations with Altium. It's just a matter of adding the extension, making sure it is installed, and then via simulate. You can do and simulate whatever you like. This is of course a very basic schematic. You can do that for much more difficult schematics, let's say, or much more complex schematics. And it's a very nice way to start already making up your schematic in Altium and being able to simulate it in Altium as well. So there's no need to go to external SPI simulations. Okay, hope you liked it. Good luck with it. Bye-bye.